Hey there everyone, welcome to a new video. My name is Harmon. Today's video is all about 12-year-old Polly Klaas, who was unfortunately abducted and murdered here in a little town called Petaluma, California. So the details are, on October 1st, 1993, 12-year-old Polly decided to have a hangout slash slumber party with two of her friends. And so they were all hanging out at the house here. And around 10:30 p.m., the perpetrator, Richard Davis, somehow was able to gain access to the house, presumably through either an unlocked window or unlocked door. He went into their bedroom. He tied up Polly's two friends. He told them basically just to turn around and count to 1,000. And then he grabbed Polly and took her out of the house. Of course, there was an immediate search for her in the area. Hundreds and hundreds of different police officers and witnesses and just people went around trying to find her. But anyway, guys, so this house right here at 427 4th Street, this is where Polly used to live and of course where she was abducted from. Now, what's interesting is the fact that Richard was able to gain access, so they must have either had a unlocked window or unlocked door. Only a few hours after the kidnapping, a babysitter who was en route to her employer's house in Santa Rosa, which is about 20 miles north, noticed that a suspicious vehicle was in the ditch, it got stuck in the ditch. And so the babysitter called her employer and said, hey, there's this suspicious vehicle stuck in the ditch. And so the owner showed up and they ended up going to a service station to call 911 and a tow truck. Some deputies arrived as well as a tow truck. And at the time, the deputies were not aware that Polly was abducted. They didn't have any idea about it, and they of course didn't have any descriptions about who the person was. What they did was they ran the perpetrator, Richard Davis, and license plate through their system, and they didn't come back with any wants or warrants. And so even though he had an open container of beer in the car, they got his car towed and he was able to be let go. The police surmised that he obviously, killed and sexually assaulted Polly within those few hours and basically temporarily buried her somewhere on that road that he crashed his car. On November 28th, 1993, about a month and a half after Polly was abducted and killed, property owner, same one who found the car in the ditch, which again belonged to Richard, they were doing some digging and other work, and they ended up discovering a pair of ballet leggings, which again they thought were immediately suspicious. So they contacted the police, and the police talked to people in the area. They found out that the only main person again in that area at that time was Richard Davis. Police, however, did not immediately contact Richard, as they kind of had him under surveillance and they didn't want to ruin that. So they waited a few days. However, when that surveillance turned out to not really provide any new clues or evidence, they ended up just going ahead and arresting Richard Davis anyway. Once he was arrested, he had been under interrogation for several days. Meanwhile, again, they were doing many, many different searches with, hundreds of different people, trying to, of course, find Polly's body. And about the third day, they were about to complete one more search, and that is when Richard finally confessed to, of course, abducting her, assaulting her sexually, and, of course, her murder. Now, another piece of evidence that they found at the scene was a palm print. Richard was finally convicted of first-degree murder and, of course, other charges related to that, including kidnapping, etc. He was given the death penalty. And as far as I know, he is still being held in the very famous San Quentin prison. He has been in numerous fights, and he almost overdosed inside the prison. Although many people have tried to kill him, because of course many prisoners do not do not appreciate a person who kills a child or, of course, you know, sexually assaults them. He, I guess, is lucky to be alive at this point. And who knows? I don't know how long death penalty cases go in California. But ones I've heard, you know, can range from, you know, 10 years to 30 years staying on death row before they kill them. So I was trying to find just a little bit more like personal info about Polly and who she was. She absolutely loved acting, and so she actually was in at least one, or if not a few, different school plays, including Carmen Sandiego. They were throwing out like one of the old sets from that play, and she asked if she could have it. And her and her mom ended up going to pick up the set, and I guess they brought it back to their house and set it up like in her bedroom as like a cool little, you know, set where they could practice different plays and stuff. Her two friends that spent the evening that night, they were kind of excited to look at the set and to practice with her. This was, you know, basically 30 years ago. Things potentially were a lot different then. I mean, maybe people left windows or doors unlocked more often than they do now. I'm not sure. But regardless, kind of one more reason why you can't always be too careful. It's always a good reason to try to lock your doors or windows, as there's people around the country just like Richard Davis who will do their best to try to prey on, you know, whoever the innocent young victims are. So I tried to find, of course, Polly's grave, if they ended up burying her, you know, at a cemetery, but turns out she was actually cremated and her ashes were kind of spread around part of the Pacific Ocean. So I'm gonna head out of here. I have a little bit of a drive to do today, so I'll see you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.